蛮顺利的。这样只是想知道说至今有没有什么是遗憾的事情。
遗憾的事情，确实是有的。我想我觉得比较遗憾的一件事，就是在我的外婆过世之前，我没有机会对她有更深一层的认识和了解。当然她是我的外婆，所以在成长的岁月当中，我就是跟她有很多接触的机会。可是我觉得当她病重而且后来过世之后，特别是看了我妈妈的书之后，我就发现其实外婆的人生当中确实是有很多坎坷的故事。那么可能当时她觉得我年纪太小，她也不跟我说这些。现在呢，想要让时光倒退是不可能的了，所以我只能够从书中了解，完完全全的了解我的外婆。
她过世时候你几岁？
他其实是2009年过世的。不过之前因为这个患病的缘故啊，所以他有一段时期是相当衰弱的。
你中学是在哪里就读？
中学是在来佛士女中。
出院是
在华初。
那么我想知道一下，对你影响力最大，但你对你人生里面给你影响力最深的是什么人？是师长或者是家人？
一生当中对我影响最深刻的人，我想应该是我的母亲。
为什么呢？
我想第一是她给了我很多东西，她教导了我很多。我想首先对于这个华语我的语音是我妈妈教出来的。那么我妈妈她对于写作的一种爱好我觉得她也把这种爱好传给了我。那么妈妈对于这个处事待人方面她也教导了我非常多。最重要的就是这个做人要耿直，是非要分明，还有就是待人一定要宽厚。
那你自己有写作吗？他把写作的爱好传给了你，你都写了什么东西？
我学生时代的时候写的比较多，后来工作，其实我们的工作有很多的写作，不过这个是专业方面的一种写作，是公文方面的写作。那么接下来我不知道还有没有时间，就是回到像学生时代那样子，就是一些休闲式的写作，我不知道还有没有这个机会。
Okay, may I just press you on the foreigner issue that you were talking about earlier and how the government has since implemented more stringent measures to moderate the inflow of foreigners. But the question is, why didn't the measures come earlier before the unhappiness was so significant? And during your time at MPS, did you ever voice dissent, or did you ever tell your immediate superiors that you disagreed with them on certain things?
Well, I think the reason why there has been more foreigners coming, especially to be part of the economy, I think that really reflects a demand in the economy. The way our system works is that we will not bring in foreign workers ahead of time or where there are no jobs for them to fill. So first, there must be an economic demand. Employers must be prepared to hire. And I think that from, say, 2005, 2006, 2007, and up to 2008, that was a period where there really were economic opportunities for Singapore. And if at that point we had slowed down or had said no to bringing in foreign workers and foreign manpower, then I think that really would have been to the detriment of the economy, which would ultimately also hurt the interests of our people. So I don't think it's a case where there are internal disagreements. I think, especially as someone who's worked on the issue for some time, I do understand how it has evolved. But as I've mentioned just now, I think the pace of intake should not be too fast. And I also believe that the government is of this view.
Okay, I wanted to go back to a question on your time in China.
Okay.
Sorry, I'll make it fast. I just want to ask you whether is there anything that you learned from the Chinese people there in terms of governance from your time in China?
Okay. I think my time in China has been very interesting, and it's really been very educational. I think what I learned in China is that, you know, in a country of 1.3 billion people, governance is a very complex subject. And things that we take for granted in a smaller country like in Singapore, you simply can't do the same when you go there and expect to see the same sorts of situations and outcomes that you do here. So I think the most important thing is to really recalibrate your the lenses through which you view the society and its people.